جايين من كل مكان للصويرة زينة البلدان زوروا ونرجع فرحان.
Be sure to have Rabotai today. We are in the middle of Sukkot. And what I want you to understand today is what it is, the connection between us and Sukkot. What thing can we learn from Sukkot? You know, Sukkot, it's a completely different between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, because Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, it's Avodah Shebalev. It's something that we work on ourselves to be near Hashem, close to Hashem. And Sukkot, it's you are with Hashem. Even on Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, we are with Hashem. But not, there is a little bit of fright. We're afraid, you know. It's not the same like you are in front of the judge, and he look at you. Then if you are in the street and you see the Jews walking, it's not the same. There is a big difference. So what it is, what it is Sukkot for us now? What can we learn? Why Hashem gave us Sukkot after Rosh Hashanah and Kippur? It must be a reason that we have to understand. You know, there is two kinds of sentiment. You know, there is kind of sentiment that it's a sentiment that it came with emotion, and there is sentiment that there is no emotion. Just it's like you go to the airport, you see people waiting, yeah. So there is family, relative, that they are waiting. You can see through their eyes, who they are looking for. There is other people, taxi driver, that as well they are waiting. What's the difference between them? The taxi driver is looking for customers, but the family, a father that is waiting for his son. So you can see emotion in his eyes. You can see, you know, there is, I was thinking about something. You know, there is a balloon. A balloon, yes. A balloon that, you know, is full with air. You release it and he fly. But it's empty inside. There is nothing. And there is an airplane. A plane is full when it take off. A plane that take off, there is people there. There is something there. A balloon that, when a balloon take off, it's nothing, you know. It depends how you take off. You take off empty or you take off full. On Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, we take off. But how are you inside? Are you empty inside or full inside? For me, only on Sukkot you realize if you are empty or full. If you are really full of emotion, or just you are the same. Like, you know, because every year we do Rosh Hashanah, Rosh Hashanah. You know, why a lot of people don't really do teshuva? You know, every year they repeat, and always it's the same. You know why? Because Rav Shach, Alav Shalom, explained that to make a change in yourself, you have to go step by step. You cannot say, I'm going to be a tzaddik. If you think that you're going to be a tzaddik, you'll be only a rasha. You have to take off slowly. You cannot take off, look at a plane. With the plane take off, you don't reach quicker, 20,000 feet high. No, you go meter, you know, you fly meter by meter. Even when you want to come down, to land, it doesn't land quick, it lands slowly. So you can be safe. So you understand? So Rav Shach said, a lot of people, they want to fly, they want to take off very, very high, you know, the same day of Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. So they fail at the end. If you want to take off, you have to go slowly. And that's why a lot of people, I know a lot of people that they want to change in 1 minute. It's impossible. You will explode. You cannot change in 1 minute. You will explode. And I think this is, that's what Rav Shach Alav HaShalom explained. He said, this is the reason why a lot of people, fail. You know that Arizal HaKadosh said that between Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, between the 40 days, Elul, till Rosh Hashanah, and Rosh Hashanah, till Kippur, a man should throw through his eyes some tears. He must cry. Why? Because when you cry, at least you feel that there is something missing on you, between you and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But if you don't cry, if you cry, that means that you want really to do a small change on yourself. But if your eyes are dry, no tears, nothing, that means there is not change. And that's why, baby, it's my own experience. On Kippur, when I start to pray on Kippur, I don't cry. But I train my body to the tefillah of Yom Kippur, and then tears start to come. I mean, it cannot come like, because to feel what you did all year between you and Hashem, it takes some time during Kippur. It cannot come in one shot, in one minute. It will come little by little. But if you start to cry from the beginning, so what's left for the end? If from the beginning you start like cry, no. Slowly, make yourself understand the mistakes that you did during all year. Then you will understand. You know, on the Avodah, to serve Hashem, Behemet, you need to feel a full emotion. And I think the real emotion, a happiness emotion between you and Hashem, it comes on Sukkot. First, did you feel something during Rosh Hashanah and Kippur? Did you feel something? Did you feel any deep emotion? Do you feel guilty about what you did? Did you take some Kabbalot, compromiso? Did you compromise yourself something to HaKadosh Baruch Hu? A lot of people, they take on themselves, I want to be a tzaddik. I'm sure this is only Ma'ase Satan. It is Satan who tell you that you want to be a tzaddik. He said, no. First, one by one. First, start one. You know, unfortunately, to repair a car, do you think the mechanic, the one who he will repair the car in one minute? No, he will start looking for everything. You know, yesterday there was a woman who came to tell me yesterday that her husband, they made all kind of tests. They know that he has cancer, but they don't know from where it comes, and that's a problem. Sometimes the doctors can detect the cancer is here, so we have to focus to repair this side. But unfortunately, they don't know. So the doctor said the only way we can treat him is to do cancer in all the body. We have to do chemo in all the body because we don't know. We know that he has cancer, but we don't know from where it comes from. We don't, and there is all kind of photos. They don't know. Unfortunately, God forbid, a man, if he knows what he did bad during the year, so we correct it. But if he doesn't know, but he knows that there is something missing, so that means that he has cancer everywhere. So his teshuvah should be a real teshuvah. It couldn't be in one shot. And then whatever he can do, it's like an empty balloon that he flows. He has to try to correct everything one by one. Not in one shot. If you want to repair in one shot, it's like he said to Hashem, Hashem, forgive me for all what I did. Now, that you remain an empty balloon. No, it's impossible that you don't remember something that you did. You start, you will see. That's why on Yom Kippur we say Al-Hayt, Shehat Torifani. There's a lot of Al-Hayt, 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 you know, for the sin that we did, for the sin. Because we don't take a risk. You know, the tzaddikim, they pray the same way like the Rishayim. I understand the Rasha when he pray, you know, he did a lot of bad things. But a tzaddik, he did nothing. Why a tzaddik has to say, for the sin I did, I stole money, I curse my parents. Yeah, tzaddik. And besides, it's your parents, you never answer them. How can a tzaddik can blame himself for things that he didn't know? Well, unfortunately, there is no a tzaddik that he did not do a sin in his life or during that year. So he will not take a risk. Which one? Because a tzaddik always will say, but I did nothing. I did nothing. So because he said he did nothing, so we accuse him that you did everything. You understand? So you accuse him, you did everything. So now you have to say, hatati, aviti, pashati, rashati, ganafti, all kinds, because you never know. It's like this man that we don't know. He has a cancer, but we don't know from where. So we have to do him chemo in all his body. Because we don't know what. My friend, there is Rosh Hashanah and Kippur Elul with a big teshuva. Now, what guarantee we have? And of course, full of emotion, we did a big tefillah, good tefillah. But now, unfortunately, after Rosh Hashanah, Kippur, after Elul, I still have some doubt. What if all those days they were full of teshuva, full of tefillah, full of connected to Hashem? When Sukkot will come, we will feel something. There is a kind of happiness that you will feel. That it's like a feeling that you are, if you were on Rosh Hashanah and Kippur in front of Hashem, the big judge, and you'll be frightened, on Sukkot you will feel a little bit light. You will feel a little bit relief. You will feel something. There is something that you feel. That's why we call Sukkot Zman Simchatinu, the moment of our joy. What that mean, the moment of our joy? It's something that you don't know. It will come from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I mean, look, I was saying last week, when you take the lulav and the etrog, you pray with it. According to the Kabbalah, when you move the lulav, you kill all those bad malachim that you created. My question was, but all those bad malachim that I created, I destroyed them on Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. That's finished. So why those malachim remained? Those bad malachim, they remained. From where they remained? But I destroyed them. So for this, there is two answers. I was thinking about two things. First, sometimes you can think that you killed somebody, but still alive. Yeah. I saw a small video about a buffalo that he was fighting a lion. You know, usually the lion beat the buffalo. And really, and the buffalo, he kicked the lion, and we saw the lion fall on the floor. Like a dead, you know, he was dying. Suddenly we saw the lion wake up and he jumped to the buffalo. And again the buffalo. He kicked him. Again, a big fight. Then the lion fell. That's it. Now he was dying. And it seemed that the buffalo was happy. And the buffalo was bleeding. But the lion dead. And suddenly we saw again the lion wake up, and we saw the buffalo, that he was shocking, because in his mind, the lion died. And you know what that we saw? Incredible. There was another buffalo came, and he kicked the lion, then really they killed him once for all. Sometimes a person, he thinks that he killed the Yetzer Hara. sometimes the parents think that all the avirot that he did, all the malachim, the angels that create through the avirot that he did, say, he did that teshuva, and that's it, now they disappear. And there you see them coming back again, because his teshuva was not 100% teshuva. So it's like he made the malachim in the coma, but they were still alive. So on Sukkot they wake up. Not they wake up, they are bleeding because they've been injured in Kippur and Rosh Hashanah, but still they are alive. On Sukkot we finish with them. When we do the lulav, this is the other buffalo came help you. The mitzvah, when we do the lulav, we move the lulav and the etrog with our hands and we pray to Hashem. So we finish. That's why we say, Hosanna, 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 Ani Vahu. Oh, Vahu is Gematria Torah.
Vahu,
Ani Vahu is Gematria 17. In 17, it's Torah. Because by Sukkot we take the we compromise to Hashem that by Ezrat Hashem we will study the Torah. Because all the sin that we did all the year, because we did not respect the halacha. So now we do teshuva that we respect the halacha. And to respect the halacha, you have to study the Torah. To respect the halacha, you must study the Torah. So Baruch Hashem on Sukkot, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, first, we feel full emotion in the Sukkah, and we feel something that we did different. We are not anymore afraid. We feel a little bit more different. And even if still we have some Averot in our hand, still the lion is not dead completely, we finish with him on Sukkot. With the Lulav, with the Arava, with the Etrog, with the Hadas. And I think this is, I want to tell you something incredible, something that I explained this week. I said this week, why we take the Arava and the Etrog and the Hadas and the Lulav, the four of them, we pray with them. So the Hadas represent the eyes, the Arava represent the lips, the Etrog represent the heart. The lulav represents the body. That means that on Sukkot, we say to Hashem, Ribono Shel Olam, now we promise you that we serve you with all our body, with our eyes, our lips, because most of the avirot we do them with the eyes, or the Lashon Hara with the lips. Eyes, we see things that we should not see. The body that we go to place that we should not go. And the heart, we use the heart for bad things. Somebody asked me, what about the brain? So I said, the brain and the heart is the same. It's the same. The heart and the brain is the same. So, listen to this. So why we pray with all this? The answer is, we promise Hashem that we will change. We will not be like we've been last year. Our heart this year will be different. It will not be my body here and my heart there. I mean, I will take my heart close to my body, close to my eyes. I will not be a double person. I serve Hashem with my eyes, I look at the book, and I talk Lashon Hara with my mouth. Or my heart go around to look what it should not look. I mean, I take them all together, we will serve Hashem. It's like a plane. I will take the example from the plane. The plane, if there is all the lights on, blue, that means everything is perfect. But if there is a light that it's red, the pilot will not take off because there is something missed, there is something wrong with the plane. You understand? I mean, just imagine, you know, in the plane, there is there like a machine that if something wrong, you hear the machine, you know, like an alarm. I mean, the pilot is not mad to take off the plane if there is an alarm in the plane. You understand? He should see everything perfect. So when we come to Sukkot, we pray to Hashem, it should not be an alarm from the eyes. Hey, you are not clean. Hey, your mouth is not clean. when I come to Sukkot to pray to Hashem, there should not be any alarm coming from my mouth, from my eyes, from my body, from my heart. The four of them should be clean, working Hashem together. Now the tzaddik. Look at the tzaddik. The tzaddik, now I want to ask you one question, Leo. Take the hadas. Is the hadas, what is the hadas in Spanish?
No, hadas.
Hadas, look. Now the hadas. Really the hadas, we compare the hadas to the eyes, yes? Do the hadas can see? No, why? It's not fruit, it's a herb. He cannot see. Do the araba that represent the lips can see? No. But with my eyes, I can see, yes? With my lips, I can talk, yeah? Do the etrog, is there any blood in the etrog? No, it's the etrog, yes? It's just the etrog represent the heart. Do lulav, do the lulav walk? No, it's the lulav, it's the lulav, it's only a, it's a piece of, from a tree, from the from a tree. Well, you know, the tzaddikim, when we pray with all these four equipment, they consider themselves exactly like the eyes, like the hadas. The same way that the hadas don't see, the tzaddikim never use their eyes to see what they should not see. The same way that the etrog, the araba, he don't talk, so the tzaddikim, they will make sure that they are exactly like the araba, that they will never talk something bad. So that means, on Sukkot, you compare yourself like the etrog, araba, hadas, and the lulav. Exactly. Like my grandfather, Rabbi Chaim Pinto. For me, Rabbi Chaim Pinto, he was like the araba, the etrog, the hadas, and the lulav. He was like this ikel. Why? He was a big tzaddik. He would never use his mouth for bad things. He would never use his eyes for bad things. His body, his heart always was clean, and his brain. So this is the tzaddikim. So on Sukkot, if really we did a good Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, on Sukkot, we feel everything easy for us. We will feel Hashem in the Sukkah. We will feel our body like the etrog, the araba, the hadas. We feel light. We feel like not a empty balloon that flow. An empty balloon like flow. No, we feel like a plane full with no alarm and take off and go slowly. Take his capacity of taking off. Then he goes by automatic. There is nothing to stop him. That's it. He's not automatic now. A lot of times you see the pilot walk in the plane. Huh? Who is the pilot? Who will take care of the plane? The plane is automatic. And the plane is automatic. Is everything is under control. We have to be the same, under control. We have got to control ourselves. And we have to be so close to Hashem that everything is automatic. Even if Hashem v'shalom, you want to do something bad, Hashem will provide that we will not do it, because you are already in automatic. When Hashem will help you, will guide you, when you are in automatic. But when you begin, so it's your work. It's your work. You begin, it's your work. After, Hashem will take care of you. So, you see, to feel happiness, Zman Simchat Inon Sukkot, and to feel that you are light, and that you are full of Torah, full of mitzvot, you train yourself to see, are you like the araba? Are you like the etrog? Look at them, it's an image. You have them in your hand. Are you the same? Or no, or just you are doing a maquillage. Just like in Purim, we talk digizment. You know, we digaz a digizment, yes. A digizment. Are you acting with a digizment clothes, or are you yourself? Look at the etrog. Look at the mirror. Look at yourself in the mirror. Are you you, or is there somebody else? So, probably, not everyone has the chance, unfortunately, that he is 100% clean on Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. So Hashem give you Rosh Hashanah Rabbah. He give you Sukkot to repair, to finish. To finish with all those avodah that you did. That's because, you know, I saw in a book, I think it's the Maharsha. I'm sure it's the Maharsha who said, people think that Kippur, when you do Kippur, you destroyed all the malachim, bad malachim that you did, that you created during the year. The Maharsha says it's a mistake. Because sometimes those averot that you did, they're still alive. Just Hashem, he hide them somewhere in the Shamayim. They are like, Hashem, he hide them, but they are not completely dead. They are not completely destroyed. Because Hashem, he wants to see how much you repair yourself. I saw in a book who said, there is people who did 60 Kippur, and out of the 60 Kippur, maybe they never did a Kippur. Why? Because they did Teshuvah, but the Teshuvah that they did, it was not 100 Teshuvah. So the Averot, Hashem, because you did Teshuvah, he hide them. Hashem wait for a real Teshuvah. When you do a real Teshuvah, we destroy it completely. So it's up to you. So of course, we believe in Hashem that we did a good Teshuvah. We believe that Baruch Hashem we did a good Teshuvah. So if you believe that you did a good Teshuvah, so all your avarot are destroyed. Now, you have to be careful not to be too. Now, Rosh Hashanah Kippur, you've been so close to Hashem. How can you know that you remain close to Hashem on Sukkot? But if in Sukkot you are somebody else, I mean, you are the same as you were before. So that means you are two. You are. It's like you don't have your body under control. On Rosh Hashanah Kippur, you have to feel that everything is under control. When Sukkot comes, you're completely under control. You feel everything in your hand. Otherwise, on Sukkot, you will feel that nothing is under control. You know, Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, your teshuva is with fright. You are afraid of Hashem. You don't eat much, you know, you're afraid, shofar, ba 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 ba. But Sukkot, you eat, you enjoy. So Sukkot, it's masmahat, it's another life. It's the contrary of Rosh Hashanah and Kippur and Elul. No, it's the contrary. Now you have to watch yourself. Do you do Nitila before you eat? Do your avodah of Hashem, it's mechor, it's better than the last time? So that means that you're completely changed. But if on Sukkot your life become like before Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, so that means there was no change in Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. So for me, Sukkot is the test. Sukkot, it's the test. How? Now it's like a plane. Now there is a problem in the plane. We fix it. Now we test it. If it's good or not, so all the mechanism, you know, they try to see if everything is under control. Otherwise, it's a problem. So for me, Sukkot is the test. Are you the same as you were before Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, or you change? If after Rosh Hashanah and Kippur you feel happiness, you feel close to Hashem, you feel emotion with Hashem, you feel, I want to go to pray, you want to wash your hand, to eat, you do Birkat Hamazon, it's a big change. So your test is right, now you can take off. Now just go, don't worry. And when you take off, easily, slowly, slowly. My friend, last night I heard a Rav talking about Midot. He talked very well. But I know that Rav. Very jealous. No midot. I wanted to tell him, you are talking about the tzaddikim, that on Sukkot you see the change on them. You talk well. What about you? So for me, it's a problem. And I saw something. People were not listening. People were eating, talking. Why? Because if you want that your word will be listening, if you respect what you say. But if you don't respect what you say, it's like, if you don't... So, Hashem, Dvarim Shiyotzim Min HaLev, Nichnasim LaLev. When your words come from your heart, so they go through the heart to somebody else. So I was sorry for him, because it's good. Square for all what you say, but do you respect what you say? You anyway. A person should know not to be two people. You were two before Rosh Hashanah Kippur. You were Batman, you do Teshuvah on Rosh Hashanah Kippur. Now we have to see the change on Sukkot. But if on Sukkot you see there is no change, that means, and you act like a tzaddik, so it's a big problem. That is a big mistake. It's better to be a Rasha than be tzaddik and Rasha. God bless you.
حايم بينتو وقف لنا زي خوف